Last chance saloon for Slupski, who admitted he almost resigned after his side lost to Bristol City last week. But things started to look up for the Russian when Fraser Campbell maintained his composure to cut inside and put the Tigers in front. Wednesday mustered just 5 shots on target in November, and they didn't manage one in the first half here either. Adam Reach nearly changed that in the second period, and he's been denied by the post, while Jordan Rhodes saw his follow-up blocked. Slupski compared the situation at Hull to a Shakespearean drama this week, and there was to be plenty of theatre on the pitch here as the game reached its climax. First, a Wednesday equaliser in confusing circumstances. It looked like Gary Hooper's strike had been ruled out for offside, only for referee Mike Jones to award the goal after consulting his assistant. Then the hosts, who were unbeaten in their previous 6 league games, felt they should have had a penalty, as Reach's shot appeared to be blocked by the arm of Hull's Michael Dawson before Barry Bannon eventually shot wide. All the referee gave, though, were some marching orders to Carlos Carvajal for his protests, as the Owls boss took on the role of the villain. Despite his absence, Wednesday took the lead with 5 minutes left when Hooper got on the end of Ati Miyuhu's knockdown and found the bottom corner. Suddenly, it looked like the writing was on the wall for the only manager left on the touchline. But just when it seemed like Slupski's days on Humberside were numbered, there was a twist that even the Bard would have been proud of. In the 95th minute, the ball found its way to Dawson, whose scuffed effort crept in. So all's well that ends well for the Hull boss, just. The same can't be said for his opposite number, though.